Hi everyone, Seth Rudetsky here. I've been doing these deconstructions to lead up to my Deconstructing Broadway show that's going to be in London on August 10th. And every time I go to the gym, like, I listen to music, and kind of throughout the months, I'm always like making a little list of like, I've got to deconstruct this, I've got to deconstruct that. And I have a whole list of a little playlist on iTunes, like deconstructions to do. This was not planned today, but of course I have to do it because it is Elaine Stritch. So I first heard Elaine Stritch when I heard the Company Cast album because my high school was doing it. We did Company when I was in 10th grade, 14 years old, really appropriate. I literally had no idea what the show was about. I was Harry, I had to sing Sorry Grateful. You know, you're always sorry, you're always grateful. I basically, my acting would have been the same if I had been just like, la, 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 la. Had no idea what the song was about, or the show was about. Anyway, the point is, but I loved the music, loved the cast album, and was obsessed with so much of Elaine Stritch. Because here's the deal, she wasn't a great singer. I mean, that wasn't, you know, she wasn't this amazing Broadway belters, but she had an incredible uniqueness that made her a star. And she's the epitome of you take what you have and you make it work. And she worked it. So the first thing I want you to hear is this Company cast album. I'm just going to play you my favorite moments from Company. This is her and Poor Baby. If you know what Poor Baby is about, you know, the whole show Company is about The Bachelor and all these married friends. So there's all these married women, and Bobby's on a date, and they're all like, you're not allowed to date anybody because you're secretly my boyfriend. It's this weird, like, you're my boyfriend, you're my child, and I want you to, but just incredible jealousy. So this whole song is about, you should not be with this woman, she's bad for you, I only want what's best for you, you should be with someone else, but no actual reason why he should be with someone else and not this woman. So they're all singing, and they have to go, you know, no one. And they're all singing this phrase, and they all are great at it. But there's something so unique about Elaine. She goes, you know, no one. It's the verb on no one. I'm not the verb, the vowel. You know, no one. It just works for me. So first, let's hear that, because I'm obsessed with it. No one. Okay, here we go.
You know,
this is Barbara Barry.
No one wants you to be happy more than I do.
Do you hear that? No one. I love that. Okay, one more time. So they go, isn't she a little bit well? And they're just coming up with all these things that are wrong with her. Dumb, tacky, vulgar, old. And Elaine's, or, you know, Joanne's issue is that she's tall, which maybe is valid, but then she literally goes, she's tall enough to be your mother. Okay, that isn't the expression. Maybe she's old enough to be your mother. It's brilliant Sondheim writing. But Elaine is also brilliant at it because, first of all, her tall, it's like this foghorn. Dumb, tacky, vulgar, old. Tall, like it's just an amazing, crazy cutting through, and then it's supposed to be tall, and then I think the melody is like she's tall enough to be your mother, but it's really too low for Elaine, but she makes it work. She's like she's tall enough to be your mother, so she kind of has to fake the low notes, but it totally works. So let's just listen to that because I'm obsessed with it. Listen how the foghorn just cuts through on the word tall. Okay, then she has to go, poor, she sings kind of the bass harmony, poor baby all alone, and then she goes back up with the ladies, throw it, you know, it reminds me of, you know, when Bosom Buddies, when like B. Arthur's down the octave, but then she's like, just turn to your bosom buddy, you know, it's sort of like, I'm kind of a bass, but once in a while I will go up the octave if need be. So Spada, she goes up the octave, and then I love the tremolo at the end and the muted brass. Okay, here we go. Foghorn.
Tenderness he's ever known. For
got her. Okay, so now let's talk about line readings. This is her line reading and being alive, and it's the kind of thing where it's a great line, but when she says it, you're like, I want to be friends with you. There's something so likable. It's just like that. It's the ultimate likable, smart friend, you know? So listen to the line reading. I'm obsessed with it.
Someone to need you too much. Someone to
Dean
know
Jones.
You too well. Someone to pull you up short, to put you through hell.
To see what you look for, you know.
You're not a kid anymore, Robbie. I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, you know.
Okay, now what's so great about that? I mean, you know, I hate to deconstruct a line reading, and I don't think she purposely was like, here's how I'm going to do it. What I love is, you're not a kid anymore, Robbie. She adds like a little app, I don't think you'll ever be a kid, and she hits kid. I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, kiddo, and also does the I'm running out of air. So it's the laugh, the kid, and the running out of air that I'm obsessed with. Okay, one more time, if you will.
Someone to put you through hell.
To see what you look for, you know.
You're not a kid anymore, Robbie. I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, you know.
Isn't that great? It's just so likable. One more time. I love the line reading.
To put you through hell.
To see what you look for, you know.
You're not a kid anymore, Robbie. I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, you know.
So great. Okay. Now, here's the beginning of the show. This is the beginning of Company. And, you know, the whole show, like I said, is about married couples and Bobby. So, obviously, there's a busy signal. Now, for those of you under 40, a busy signal was when you would call someone, not even this, you'd call someone, they'd be on the phone, and you'd hear a busy signal. So, first you hear a real busy signal, and then in the orchestra, it takes over. Near, 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 just spot that. But, anyway, I just love her line reading on, Robbie! No one could ever recreate that. Like, there were a lot of Joannes, but no one could recreate that. Just that, I'm your sassy best friend. Just the quality is so amazing. Listen to this. Okay. So first, a busy signal. A real busy signal. Now the guitar takes over.
Robbie,
Robbie, Bubby, Bravo. Robbie, Robbie, Bobby, 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 Bobby,
Bobby,
Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, Bobby, But the ultimate of what I love is the end of the opening number. So they're all going, you know, phone rings, door chimes. Then they go, the point is, they go, we love you. And they had to hold this long note because they were coming down the elevator. So the point is, they're holding this long note of love. And everyone's like, you know, love in harmony. Stritch is literally a half step flat. But obviously no one cared because they actually moved the microphone closer to her mouth. That's what I love because Sondheim's a smart person. He's got a good ear. And it wasn't like, oh, my God, turn her microphone off. They're like, bring her microphone up. Because it's just as, I don't know, there's something about, like, you're like, who's an amazing person that's a half step flat and literally couldn't care less? So spot the half step flat. And what I also love is that the note is held forever and ever. And maybe after, like, 10 seconds, she's like, I'm out. And then she's like, I'll just come back in when the song begins. So just spot it. She's like, first, like, a half step flat, but, like, selling it, but, like, a half step flat. And then she's like, oh, my God, it's a long note. And then it's like, you know what, I'm not going to, because everyone's kind of staggering their breathing. So they're like, you know, I'm going to stop singing, and I'll come back in to hold it. She's like, cut. I'm just going to wait till the song part begins. But I love it. There's something so sassy about it. Here we go. Is it? Yeah. It's brazen, but I love it. Hold on, listen one more time. like, I'm out. All right, rest in peace, Elaine Stritch, and brava.